From NBC News, this is Today with Matt Lauer and Ann Curry.
We begin this morning on a Tuesday morning with a question. At the Jerry Sandusky trial, will Sandusky himself take the witness stand? NBC's Michael Isikoff is at the courthouse. Michael, good morning to you.
Good morning, Matt. Jerry Sandusky faces the decision of his life today, whether to testify in his own defense as his sex abuse trial races to a finish. Jerry Sandusky continues his defense today after Monday's emotional testimony from the prosecutor's final witness, the mother of one of his alleged victims. The woman testified she was initially excited when Sandusky, a very important person, she said, offered to take her son for weekend visits. Sobbing, she testified her son wanted to stop going to Sandusky's home, but she never knew why. I would ask him why, and he'd just say he didn't feel like it, and I'd make him go anyways. You still don't specifically know what happened to him, asked Chief Prosecutor Joseph McGinnigan. No, I don't. I just can't imagine. Do you feel responsible? Yes, I do. Last week, her son, known in court documents as Victim 9 and now 18 years old, testified he was repeatedly sexually assaulted in Sandusky's home over a three-year period. How are you supposed to tell your mom something like that, he said.
This was the only mother to testify. Her testimony had a resonance for jurors as parents in a way that maybe the victim's testimony itself did not.
Later, Sandusky's lawyers began his defense, calling a string of character witnesses, including another former Penn State assistant coach, Dick Anderson, who said the defendant had a wonderful reputation in the community. Anderson also said that as a coach, he too had often showered with young boys after sports. Did you hug them, Prosecutor McGinnigan asked? No, I did not. David Pasquinelli, a consultant to Sandusky's charity, said he saw mutual admiration between children and Sandusky. I saw a lot of goofing around. Jerry had a very unique way, and many of us were inspired by how he could relate to youth of all ages. But none of the defense witnesses Monday spoke directly about the sex abuse allegations against Sandusky.
I don't think today there was one hole poked in the prosecution case.
The defense lawyers do plan to argue the alleged victims and their lawyers are motivated by hopes of raking in big bucks from civil lawsuits. And they do have to decide very quickly whether to take the biggest risk of all, putting Sandusky himself on the witness stand. Now, the defense may also introduce evidence that some of Sandusky's behavior is caused by a rare psychiatric malady called histrionic personality disorder. But either way, the defense has said it now plans to rest by midday Wednesday, meaning this case could go to the jury as early as Thursday. Matt?
I'm Michael Isikoff. Thank you very much.